I'm just not stoned enough to do this.
Watch, what is your problem?
Okay, yeah, so we'll just, tomorrow then.
Love, right?
Yeah, can't live with it. Can't live without it.
No.
Actually realized the other day that I think I could go like 8 months with no sex and I would be absolutely fine.
Well, look at you.
Yeah. You okay? I mean, that looked,
I'm fine.
Oh, okay.
She's just dramatic.
Yeah.
She just needs like a 24-hour cooling period, then that's it. We're good.
And you are doing well, I presume?
Oh, man. It's been so great with her. We, it's like every day. It's like a new day. Yeah, we meet up and, she's at work and then I see her and she's like, has all these things to say all the time and I do too, and they're always new things, never repetitive. And then we just kind of go back and forth and, it's like this whole tennis match of ideas.
A conversation, yeah, with two people.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, Marnie, you are so obsessed with success and who's who and what they have and how they got it. Like, I was looking at Tally Schiffen the other night and I thought you probably wish she was your best friend. It's pretty transparent. So you could tell everyone to tune in and hear your best friend on Fresh Air.
I like being around people who know what they want.
People like you? Because what do you want besides like a boyfriend with a luxury rental? Seriously, that's where your priorities are. You have always been this way and now it is worse.
No, you know what? You are worse. I can't take you anymore. You think that everyone in the world is out to humiliate you. You're like a big, ugly fucking wound.
Adam says you are teetering on the edge of psychotic misery, but you're smiling so wide that no one can tell. You are the wound.
I am not the wound. You are the wound.
You're the wound.
You're the wound.
You are the wound.
Stop saying that. I am not a wound. You are a wound.
Maybe we're overanalyzing this, and the issue is just that I've got a boyfriend and you don't, and it's as simple as that. That's awesome. That is a really, really mature way to deal with your fucking feelings!
I would back the fuck off if I were you.
Oh, I'm fucking terrified. Seriously. I mean, I'm not, but I probably should be, considering you've been batshit crazy ever since Charlie broke up with you.
Yeah? Well, you've been crazy since before I even met you. You've been crazy since middle school, when you had to masturbate 8 times a night to stave off diseases of the mind and body.
Okay, that is my most shameful, painful, private secret, okay? And it might sound like a joke, but it is not fucking funny to me. And that is why I told you not to tell anyone. I didn't tell anyone. I would never do that. I am just telling you now. I would never tell anyone that. I am a good fucking friend. Unlike you, you are a bad friend. Maybe that's not what's important to me right now. I don't really give a shit about being a good friend. I have bigger concerns.
You know what? Thank you. That is all I needed to hear. I'm done.
What is that supposed to mean?
I do not want to live here anymore. Not with you.
Yeah, well, I don't want to live with you anymore either. And I am not just saying that because you said it. I was thinking it, but I did not want to say it because I am a good friend and you are a bad friend.
Fine.
Great. Awesome. Very good.
From New York, therefore you are just naturally interesting, okay? It is not up to you to fill all of the pauses. You are not in danger of mortifying yourself. The worst stuff that you say sounds better than the best stuff that some other people say.
I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. 'Cause all the roads we have to walk are winding, and all the lights that lead you there are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. 'Cause maybe you're gonna be the one that says,
ah! Oh my God, you scared me so much.
Are you okay?
Don't get up. Jessa.
What?
You just snot rocketed in the tub.
That was gross?
That's so gross. I'm sorry you're upset, but that is so gross.
Oh, you wouldn't do that?
Not even I would do that. I pee in every bathtub I ever get in, and I wouldn't do that. Honestly. Get it away. Float it back in your way. Float it back your way. Even in your area!
Leave it, it's gross!
I really love you. I'm really sorry you're sad. I just need to get rid of your snot!
I love you.
Are you okay?
I'm very moved.
You are?
Yeah. People finding each other.
I love you.
Taking shelter. I'm very moved.
But they just met like 2 weeks ago.
No.
Time is rubber band.
And now with the power vested in me by a website that I found on the internet, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Is it Garter time?
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, come on, please.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. Oh, boy.
Your dreams are not what you thought they'd be.
All right, everybody, let's fucking cork it out.
Help?
I'm fine, thank you. It's pretty shiny, so I'll probably find it soon.
Pretty bitchin' cheese plate you brought over. My computer tells me you unfriended me on Facebook.
Yeah, well, I didn't feel like seeing you in my feed anymore.
It's not very nice.
Yeah, well, you weren't very nice. You hurt me, okay? You hurt my feelings, but I can deal with it because I have my big girl pants on.
You realize you're actually wearing...
I don't think that's funny. That's not funny to me.
Look, I don't want you to be upset with me.
Are you kidding, Ray? You don't want to date me, that's fine. Because I don't want to date you either. Because I only want to date people who want to date me. Because that is called self-respect. But I do not have to like you, okay? You were never my friend. You were only my lover. And that is now over.
You know... When I'm not around you, okay, when you just send me a text full of emojis, it is so easy to dismiss you.
What is wrong with emojis?
A panda next to a gun next to a wrapped gift? It makes no sense.
You make no sense! You rejected me and you are now insulting me and you do not get to have me like you now. So you should...
Wait, hold on, let me finish, okay? What I wanted to say is when I'm around you, I remember, okay? I remember. I remember your charm, your innocence, your strength, this beautiful, fresh, vibrant sincerity.
You know, I'm really tired of being insulted, even when it comes before a compliment. So I am now leaving.
I would like to thank everybody that spoke this afternoon. Now, final order of business. Next week's cookies. I've been the only person buying cookies for the last 3 or 4 weeks. And it might be nice if somebody else decided to step up and buy a batch. Oh, come on, guys. It's part of the deal.
Hi, I'm Adam, cookies. And I'm an alcoholic.
Hi, Adam.
Hi, Adam.
Hi, Adam.
I've been sober since I was 17. I knew I had a problem pretty early on, and I dealt with it because I didn't want to wait, and I knew it would just get worse. I felt pretty solid after I stopped drinking. I stopped coming to as many meetings, but lately I haven't felt so solid anymore. So I had this girlfriend who at first I didn't like very much, or I didn't take her very seriously, I guess. She just seemed like, you know, piece of ass. But she was persistent, man. And she just hung around and showed up at my place. And gradually it started to feel better when she was there. Wasn't love the way I imagined it. I just felt weird if I didn't know what she was up to or whatever. And I liked knowing that she was just gonna be there and warm and staying the night. And she acted like I was teaching her everything about fucking history, about sex. And she didn't know what street Central Park started on or how to use soap. And I showed her. And I wanted that chance to show someone everything. But she changed her mind about me, and it was that fast. I'm so exhausted. Okay. And I'll bring cookies. I don't really like cookies that much, so don't get mad at me if I bring the wrong shit.
Thank you, Adam. So Adam's bringing the cookies.
I'm working on my book. I'm polishing up my book, so.
That's great. All right, I'll catch you later.
Do you know that
part? Sure. The cards
are delivered.
Oh, really? Did you hear that? Mets are up 3-2.
No. I'm going to have a Jack and Ginger, actually.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I want to be able to have a nice time with you. And I should be able to show you a nice time.
Two Jack and Gingers, please.
Of growing up, I've made my peace. I'm dead, I'm done. I watch you live to have my fun. I root for you.